JB is all about batteries and what we should do with them. He left Tesla to start Redwood Materials. At its heart, it's a battery recycling company. But looked at another way, it's sort of like a lithium or nickel mine, just in reverse.
We're inventing the ways, you know, that you can basically recycle this without having a human do it, because it's too small.
How much lithium that's been used in here would you guys be able to recover? Like, what's the reuse percentage?
Almost all of it. You know, lithium, maybe more than 80%. You know, nickel, 95, 98%. Same with cobalt and copper. So, you know, it's a pretty complete process. This is just a small batch of lithium carbonate that we just made this morning. And this is sort of a chance to see, you know, what the final product is and what lithium actually looks like, you know, once you extract it from the batteries and separate it out. So, you know, this stuff is quite pure lithium carbonate. So this is actually the input precursor of how lithium gets, you know, used and built back into batteries. It is pretty neat to see it separated like this and you know that this came from batteries, you know, that were, you know, otherwise, you know, garbage and otherwise wouldn't have been recovered.
I mean, it's like the lithium, say it's been in my phone and you guys refine it. How many times can that happen? Can this just keep going on and on and on?
There's no real limit to it. There's no degradation that happens to those atoms of lithium or cobalt or nickel. And it's one of the coolest things about this is that those metals are basically infinitely recyclable. Except for the small amounts that get lost in the recycling process itself, you can basically keep doing that again and again and again. So you can start to imagine a future where you're thinking, like if we can do this 1,000 times, you know, the need for mining new materials starts to dwindle.